still cannot believe that dunk by Kemp. Good evening, everybody. I'm Ernie Johnson in Atlanta. Welcome to another doubleheader playoff night on TNT. Miami Arena is going to be rocking as the Heat and the Bulls meet in Game 3, and then it's the Blazers and Lakers from the Great Western Forum. And joining us again tonight, Atlanta Hawks head coach Bob Weiss. The Bulls, a big favorite, but for Kevin Lockery, your old assistant, this is going to be a night he never forgets, I'm sure.
Oh, I'm sure. First expansion team to make it into the playoffs. That place is going to be rocking. They've got some talent, and these fans are going to be turned on. I wouldn't be surprised if they gave the Bulls a good game.
The Lakers and the Blazers, L.A. with a lot of pride, but I don't think that carries you in this series.
Pride will carry you to a point. I think they've about reached that point, and I don't see them going past two more games.
Also tonight here on TNT, bonus coverage of Phoenix and San Antonio. The Spurs without the Admiral, without Willie Anderson, without Rod Strickland, without a chance, it would appear, but we'll see as we bring you bonus coverage later tonight. But right now, settle back and watch the doubleheader. Chicago and Miami, our first game, followed by Portland and the Lakers on TNT.
It's an historic evening at the Miami Arena. In just four seasons, Miami has gone from an expansion team to a playoff team. And tonight, for the first time in history, a state that has had Super Bowls, golf tournaments, tennis tournaments, spring training, and hurricane football will host an NBA playoff game. Hello, I'm Craig Sager. The sellout crowd is 15,008, but the demand in tickets has been so large that some seats have gone for over 10 times their face value. This is my ticket. It is also your ticket. And I invite you to join me as we go inside the Miami Arena, where the Heat logo, flaming basketballs, burning nets, and the hottest ticket around all indicate that the Heat is on.
Along with Dick Versace, this is Bob Neal from the Miami Arena. Tonight, 15,008 fans, 15,008 noisemakers, and an expansion team take on the Chicago Bulls. It was only 4 years ago that this team lost 17 games in a row. Then they won 15 games, 18 games, 24 games. This year, 38, they made the playoffs. This reminds me a little of being in Italy a couple of summers ago for televising the World Cup. The excitement in Miami is like an international sporting event going on. And Dick Versace, is it going to carry over to this team? Is it going to be to help them? They're down 2-0 here. How about coming home to play?
Bob, it absolutely has to carry over. This Miami Heat team has a better home record than the Detroit Pistons in the Palace. What they've got to do is they've got to feed off the energy that they're going to get from this crowd. And maybe the Clippers. But if they don't, they are not going to be able to get out of here with a respectable showing. They also need to have Glenn Rice or somebody step up from the inside.
Now, the Chicago defense is so good, it's why they've won so many games. They call it unleashing the Dobermans. How does Miami respond to that?
Well, I think they should start climbing the fences as quickly as they can, because when you put Horace Grant, Michael Jordan, and Scottie Pippen after you defensively, is one of the most awesome spectacles. They create turnovers. They had 15, a record-setting 15 turnovers in the last game. Kevin Lockery, Bob, has got to do something about this.
Michael Jordan, everybody was wondering if Michael Jordan would play golf when he was down here in Miami. I asked him as they warmed up. He said, no, wish I had. I said, will you play? He says, I can't. We're going home first thing in the morning. Well, not if the Heat has anything to do about it. We'll be back for the tip-off and the starting lineup right after this.
The 1992 NBA playoffs are brought to you by Bud Dry. Dry brewed so it drinks light yet satisfies completely.
They call it the Big A, the Miami Arena. 15,008 fans, the first playoff game in this franchise's history. They love the Heat. It doesn't quite have the same ring as the Bulls. Let's have a look at the starting lineup presented by Jeep Eagle. Bulls on the left with Pippen, Grant, Cartwright, Paxson, and Jordan. Rice and Long, Cycli in the middle, Shaw and Smith. We talked, Dick, about that matchup between particularly Pippen and Rice. Any other important one there early in this ballgame?
Well, I don't think there's any one more important than the Rice-Pippen matchup. If there is, it might be the tendency of Ronnie Cycli in the first two games not to express himself. He really, Bob, needs to get after it offensively. Challenge whoever is guarding him. If it's Cartwright, he should use his quickness. If it's Will Perdue, you should take him out on the court, take him off the dribble. If it's somebody like Horace Grant inside, he should use his size. But he's got to really look at the basket tonight.
Ronnie Cicely under a lot of pressure as the Miami Heat, with a history-making first playoff game at home. Michael Jordan is averaging nearly 40 points a game in this series. We are underway, the Heat with the ball. Steve Smith, the point guard. Brian Shaw came in the trade from Boston for Sherman Douglas. Looking for Rice on the baseline. 2-0 Miami.
Well, that's what they have to have, Bob. They have to have a good start and a big night from Glenn Rice.
Scottie Pippen being defended by Rice. Have the switch now, the mismatch. Pippen hard to the hoop. It's tied at 2. Backcourt pressure from Michael Jordan. See Steve Smith, just a rookie. Only played 61 games this year. That was Long, Grant Long from Eastern Michigan in his fourth year, and it's 4-2. This team shoots much better at home. One of the keys to the game, according to Kevin Lockery, is a good shooting performance. Jordan's pass intercepted. Brian Shaw, the lob, the jam!
Well, there's no excuse. Chicago could have easily gotten back. Jordan got back, protected the basket. Nobody helped him.
Well, this crowd's in love with the team at the moment, but these are the Bulls. Michael Jordan pulls up and misses. Rebound, Cicely. 6-2 Miami. Miami had a good first half in the opening game at Chicago. That was for 3. Jordan with the rebound, averaging 12 a game.
See, Ronnie Cicely right now is way behind the ball. He's got to get ahead of the ball.
Jordan with the easy no-look lob to Grant.
I
and
think
Grant
Ron,
with the lay-in.
Excuse me, Bobby. I think Ron Cycling's got a little bit of the jitters here.
Six-four Miami. First 2 minutes of the first playoff game of this expansion franchise at home. Ryan Shaw threw up a prayer, and Chicago with a chance to tie.
They need better shots than that.
John Paxson. Looking for Cartwright against Cicely. Grant Long doing a good job in the middle. And the turnover from Cartwright. It's 3-on-2. The no-look. Long missing. Rebound Jordan.
Again, Cicely 15, 20 feet behind the ball on a mid-shot. He's got to get back and make sure that the Bulls play 5-on-5. If you get in a transition game with Chicago, you're in big-time trouble.
Rice with his first personal foul of the ball game. And Pippen goes to the line. 20 points, 5 rebounds, 8 assists for Pippen. They call them Bulls 1 and 1A, Jordan and Pippen.
Well, you know, Michael Jordan right now is at a perfect crossroads between the boundless energy of youth and the hard-won wisdom of age. And that spells trouble for all his opponents in the next 4 years.
The roar of the crowd deafening already in the first 3 minutes of this ballgame. 6-5, Miami by 1. Here's that full-court pressure now.
See, what they do is they leave the big man to bring it up. You would really, Kevin would like to have Brian Shaw bring the ball up, but they overplay him, and it forced, look at the shot clock. Haven't made an entry pass, shot clock is at 11.
Down to 8 now, Smith. 6 seconds, and they're just now getting to the offense. 4-3, Smith from long range. He drains it, that's a 3.
You gotta like this rookie. Led all NBA rookies in assists this year. Had a very difficult year. Lost his mom, a tragic thing. Had major surgery. We see the steal.
3-on-1. Rice from Brian Shaw. It is 11-5, Miami. The crowd now feeding on the team and vice versa. Paxson from 19. Brian Shaw led his college team in rebounding
Rice, good move past Pippen. Offensive board for Rice.
Wonderful second effort.
To cycle it. Stripped by Michael Jordan. From 17. Rebound cycling. Heat by 6. Electric atmosphere here.
Well, one of the things I saw in game one, Bob, was that the Bulls came out tentative. They had a little bit of swagger on their countenances, and they were not ready to play. And that looks like the same countenance tonight.
3 seconds on the shot clock. 2, Cycli from the baseline. Johnny Cycli, you're right, Victor says, starting very tentative here tonight. Inside to Grant. Blocked by Cycli. Maybe that'll loosen him up.
Well, that's where he needs to be. He's the biggest guy that they have. He's their best big man. He needs to be down inside protecting. Ball goes inside. Little scramble by Brian Shaw, but Ronnie Cycli comes over and helps out. That's exactly what he has to do.
10 on the shot clock. Pippen's spin move off the glass. Cartwright, big boy. And the foul. The Bulls are now 2 of 8 shooting the ball to open this ball game.
Well, I'm looking over at the face of Phil Jackson. I know that face because I've made that face. And that face is a face saying, we are not ready to play. I hope we can weather this. We got to get through it. I certainly don't like the shot selection, and I'm very disappointed in the energy level.
Grant Long picked up the first foul for him in this ball game. Cartwright shoots a brick. You know, I think the loudest stadium in the NBA is Chicago Stadium. This, at this point here in Miami, rivals the noise in Chicago.
I hated to play here. I didn't like it here. I always thought the weather was a big distraction. And then when you got here, this Miami Heat team always fed off the crowd. And no matter what you said to your guys, you couldn't make them believe it wasn't going to be an easy game because it was an expansion team.
Bulls only 1 of 4 from the free throw line. Steve Smith off the wing. It's 13-5.
Bill Jackson wants to talk about this. I guarantee you. Guarantee.
It's a 7-0 Miami run. Listen to this crowd.
Under broadcasting rights granted by the National Basketball Association solely for the entertainment of our audience. Any publication, reproduction, or other use of the pictures, descriptions, or accounts of this game without the express written consent of the National Basketball Association is prohibited.
Well, it is cracker night in Miami. It shows how far this franchise has come. 4 years ago when they lost 17 in a row, it's fly sweater night. Fly sweater night to swat the Hornets. It didn't work. Everybody threw those down on the court after the game. You also don't see any brooms in this arena. Let's go back to Bob and Dick. And Dick, let's talk about 2 steals early in the ballgame here. Steve Smith in the circle.
Well, let's see why this steal developed. Let's watch John Paxson as he goes through. He takes a cut as the ball is attempted to go through the post, but Steve Smith doesn't go for the cut, plays the steal all the way, ends up in a nice, easy transition basket off the steal. Very difficult to stop the transition baskets in the NBA when the opposing team gets a steal.
It's been a minute 51 since Chicago has scored. Heat on a 7-0 run. Chicago shooting 2 for 8, Heat 6 for 11. Pippen.
Nice rhythm jumper. Settle him down.
There's that pressure in the backcourt. Brian Shaw helping Steve Smith. All alone, Long off the glass. Grant Long. He has 6 points.
See, that's not typical of the Chicago defense. Normally, when you come into the lane, there's as many people as the Chinese army coming after you. And it wasn't the case. Unmolested inside shot.
Grant punched away by Long. Horace Grant. Cycling with the rebound. That's his third. Cycling with 3 rebounds and a blocked shot early in the game. Glenn Rice being smothered by Scotty Pippen. Smith takes the shot to Paxson. We have a 3-on-2. Now Jordan coming. Paxson with the miss. Pippen runs it back. Cycling's 4th rebound. Brian Shaw from 19.
Well, if Brian Shaw comes alive, He's had a difficult year of the Italy, the Boston, the Italy, the trade back here. It's been difficult adjustment for him. If he can get his feelings such that he's so comfortable here, he can help this team tremendously.
Tippett against Rice having his way early, but not able to get him, knock it down. Another turnover. It was Brian Shaw with aid from Grant Long into Cicely, stripped away by Pippen. Foul on Chicago, no basket.
Well, I'll tell you what, that was a terrific pass. Anytime that the player can make the pass prior to the color guy seeing it or the coach seeing it, that's an excellent pass.
Miami 11-2 in the last 3 minutes. Kevin Lockery said it is unbelievable, in his view, what this franchise has accomplished this year. 10-point lead, 17-7, 5:13 to go, first quarter. Very patient with the offense. Long got inside of Pippen with the lay-in.
Bill Cartwright standing on the other side of the basket. Even if he has to take a foul, he has to come across the lane and challenge.
Long is 4 out of 5. Ten on the shot clock for the Bulls. Cartwright against Cycling. 6 on the shot clock. Cycling knocks it loose. 3, 2. Another steal. That's the third steal. It was Grant Long. Smith trying to post up Paxson. Count it, and he'll go to the line.
This is a wonderful rookie. This is a guy that has a brilliant future in this league.
Paxson's second personal foul.
This was the matchup they tried to exploit in game one. Not much success. Off to a fine start in game three.
21-7, the Heat tripling the score of the Bulls early. They've held the Bulls to 7 points so far. Blocked by Cicely, but counted as a goaltend. My guess is you'd say if you're his coach, but that's okay.
You see, Kevin Lockery likes the effort. He likes the fact that they came across to help defensively, the same kind of thing the Chicago Bulls are not doing.
Well, he said this team shoots better at home, I would say. Shooting 60% at the moment. 13 on the shot clock. Glenn Rice. The loose ball to Brian Shaw. Everything going Miami.
Well, they can have those kinds of nights here. They're just going to have to sustain this giddiness right now. The phenomenal shooting percentage is something that's not going to last.
Cartwright trying to look down for a baseline screen. Good defense by Miami. Cartwright over Cycle. He got a piece of that. Scottie Pippen with the rebound. Only 4 seconds remained on the shot clock. For Chicago, Pippen has 7, Grant 4. Jordan has yet to scratch. 10 on the shot clock for the Heat. 7. Rice for 3. Count it!
Oh, that's way too long a look for Glenn Rice. You cannot give him that long a look. You must get up into his chest and make him put the ball down on the floor.
Pippen trying to beat Smith off the dribble. Cycely with the block. That's his second block. 3 if you count the one that was called goaltending. Now Cycely hard to the hoop. He draws the foul. Gone is the tentativeness.
Well, that's exactly what we talked about in the open. The aggressiveness of Ronnie Cycely. He's got to continue to do that. Not only on the offensive end, Bob, but he's also got to make sure that he gets back in transition.
Next, the Portland Trailblazers and the Los Angeles Lakers. Pete Van Halen and Hubie Brown out there for that ball game.
That's a rock group.
Stay tuned right after this one.
Rockin' Hubie.
The Portland Trailblazers looking to sweep L.A. Chicago trying to do likewise here tonight at Miami, but so far the Heat at 67% having nothing to do
with it. Well, the Bulls are ice cold. I don't like the shot selection. I don't think Phil Jackson likes it. It's getting a little bit better. They seem to be very tentative. They seem to be very cautious. Jordan has only taken two shots. Look out. Something's going to happen. He's averaging 39 in this series. So I just think that, you know, you just get this impending feeling of doom or the explosion going to come. But I have seen this Miami Heat team, Bob, beat off this crowd for four quarters. I've seen them do it into triple overtime.
The Bulls' low points for a quarter this year, by the way, is 15, and their lowest first quarter output on the year is 20. And here we have 2:43 to go in the first quarter. The Bulls have just scratched double figures with 11.
Well, you know, Phil Jackson has said that his bench is sort of like sub du jour, and that he goes and picks out whoever he wants. He doesn't have a normal rotation. And right now he's got Scott Williams in there. He's got B.J. Armstrong. He'd like to see something develop.
That was illegal defense on cycling. First one's a warning. New shot clock inbound by the Bulls. Jordan, 0 for 2, has not scored. Pippen with a major league jam.
Well, Scottie Pippen is a 200% three-point shooter, Bob. I'd back right off of him and let him take a couple of threes.
Shaw from long range. Knocks it down. Shaw, 6.3 of 4. Jordan, 0 for 3. Scott Williams into the ball game for Chicago, along with B.J. Armstrong. Jordan over Brian Shaw. And Michael is now 1 for 4. His first points of the game.
I think that was a good way for Brian Shaw to play him. Back off, make him hit a couple of those out there. Certainly don't want him inspiring his own team with those unbelievable, wonderful dunks.
I was going to say the weakness of Jordan is his outside jumper. Let's say it's his least strong point. Cycling, underhanded, and he goes to the line.
Oh, that was a wonderful drop step move by Ronnie Cycling. Fakes the middle, drops the right foot back, seals the defensive player, and finishes off the glass. Takes the foul, goes to the free throw line. Kevin Lockery said he wanted to see his team get to the free throw line many more times this game.
Scott Williams picked up the personal, cycling with four and looking for more. Small. Minute 27 to go in the quarter.
Now, small wonder he wants to do that. I always feel that free throw shooting is basketball's hidden way to score. You should go into the game saying you want to get 35 opportunities.
B.J. Armstrong looking for Jordan, posting up Brian Shaw. Shaw and Jordan, same height. 10 seconds on the shot clock. Pippen gets inside. He now has 11. 33-17. Minute to go in the quarter. The most that have points that have been scored against the Bulls this year in the quarter has been 38. Miami challenging that here with 33. Bad pass from Cycli. B.J. Armstrong to Pippen. Jordan down here too. The lob broken up. Rice stripped it away. Williams with it. 42 seconds in the quarter. Jordan with the shovel pass on the baseline. 10 on the clock. It won't go for Pippen. Brian Shaw. Rice. Rebound goes to B.J. Armstrong. The Bulls have it 3-on-2. Armstrong from 15. Bulls 19, Heat 33, 17 seconds to go in the quarter.
Phil Jackson wants that defense extended. He wants to try to eat up most of this clock if he can. There's the pressure.
They're going to call B.J. Armstrong for the foul. But hold it. They call timeout before the steal. Smart move. Jess Kersey picked it up. And he pointed to where the timeout was called. It was by Steve Smith. Thus, no steal. It's a 20-second timeout with 7.6 remaining in the first quarter. 33-19 Miami.
Well, I don't think they really want this timeout right now. It just seems to me it's ill-advised. It seems to me that it's sort of one of those serendipity timeouts. You don't really mean to have it, but you got it. It's an accidental happening, and you got to live with it. I mean, that 20-second timeout could be more valuable at an end of a quarter when you want to set up a play to maybe get a three-pointer to maybe go in at half with a little extra lead. Maybe psychologically you want to gain an edge by using that timeout. Kind of a wasted one if you ask me, but don't ask.
There's Dan Marino. This is Celebrity City tonight. Dan Marino, Dick Versace, everybody's
here. I think he bought his tie where you bought yours. It's great.
He's looking good. It's called Miami Nice. Jerry Lewis is here. These are Jerry's kids, this team.
Let me ask you a question. Is Miami going to become the L.A. of the East? Is that a possibility with all these stars here?
I said that to somebody today, and they said, actually, L.A. is the Miami of the West. Thank you very much.
Oh, I see.
That's the attitude here in South Florida. They had to reset the clock here to 9.7 seconds. That's the reason this timeout lasted longer than 20 seconds. Let me just check the scoring here for Miami early. Rice has 7, Long 8, Cycli 5, Smith 7, Shaw 6. You got to call that balance.
Well, I just think that what's going to happen is that there's going to be a drop-off in this shooting. And when that occurs, you're going to have to depend on hard work. And the one thing that's a little bit upsetting, I think, to Kevin Lockery right now and his coaching staff is that when the Bulls do get a miss or a steal, then they got easy baskets at the other end. It's transition basketball at its best when you've got those guys like Jordan, Grant, and Scottie Pippen filling the lane.
9.7 to go in the quarter. Look at this defense. It'll be Chicago ball. Miami could barely get it inbounded. Chicago's strength, their defense.
Well, Kevin Lockery is all over Ronnie Nunn, and I think he's got a legitimate case. There was a lot of, you know, hands on shoulders, grabbing the jerseys. The players in this league know that officials in the last few seconds of the quarter don't like to have a parade to the free throw line, and they try to take advantage of it.
Bimbo Coles gets into the ballgame for this final couple of seconds. He's playing with 100-degree temperature. Has a cold closure tonight. Jordan, missing, has another opportunity that won't count. The Miami Heat has held the Chicago Bulls to their lowest first quarter point total of the year and lead it 33-19. At the Miami Arena, the Chicago Bulls held a 35% shooting. Miami Heat at 67%. And Pippen had 11 of Chicago's 19 points. Michael Jordan, on the other hand, only 2. Will Perdue is checked in for the Bulls.
If you think that this Miami Heat team wasn't excited about being in the playoffs, here's a quick little story. Grant Long, when Cleveland beat the Atlanta Hawks, answered his telephone at home. Hello, playoff house. And this whole crowd is excited as he was.
It's arena, the playoff house here tonight. Pippen shooting over Cycli. Pippen now with 13. He's not had any problems with this. 33-21, Miami. 12-point lead, opening moment, second quarter. Yes, Kersey with a foul on the baseline. It's on Scottie Pippen.
His first. 33, Scottie Pippen in his first.
Jess Kersey, Ronnie Nunn, and Derek Stafford, the officials here tonight.
Well, I talked to Scottie Pippen last night, and he felt the whole key to the game was going to be the Bulls' defense, that they had to really play good defense and get up after them right away, and they clearly haven't done that.
Bimbo Coles from Virginia Tech handling the ball against D.J. Armstrong. Keith Haskins has also checked in for Miami. Illegal defense called against the Bulls. Going to be a loose shot clock and an inbound on the side.
It's very, very interesting that Ronnie Cycli earned himself a double team that time. It caused the Bulls to have an illegal defense. Normally, Ronnie Cycli doesn't draw a double team for this team.
Cycli there drew actually a triple team by the time he turned around with the ball.
Well, I like Ronnie Cycli. I think he's got a lot of offensive ability, but he just has to stay aggressive.
on the baseline. Askins went for the tip-in, couldn't get it. He goes down. He's the youngster from Alabama. Armstrong wide open. Rebound was ripped out of Purdue's arms. Bimbo Cole finds Brian Shaw. 4-3. Shaw has 9.
Brian Shaw is picking a great time to find a comfort zone.
Pippen on the baseline. Brian Shaw got it.
Now, Keith Askins is a very underrated player. He was an undrafted player out of Alabama. He didn't even start on his senior year in college. Stu Inman, the personnel director, picked up on his work ethic and his athletic ability, gained 20 pounds of muscle, and now he's gained 20 pounds of confidence.
24 years old, and that's interesting. Didn't even start at Alabama.
Bill Foran, the strength coach for the Miami Heat, said that Bimbo Cole and Keith Askins are the hardest working guys on the Miami Heat team in that weight room.
13-point lead by the Heat, 10:28 to go in the half. Cycling helping with that Chicago pressure. You see how long it takes the Heat to get it across. It took 6 seconds. 16 on the shot clock when Miami goes into their offense. 9 into Cycling. They're going to get B.J. Armstrong for the foul.
Well, if they're going to continue to allow the ball to be thrown that deep into the post, that's what we refer to as a very deep post-up. See how deep he is into the paint? You can't play behind a guy down inside. You're going to have to bring across some backside help to make sure that Ronnie Cicely can't have his way in the lane like that. I would suggest that if Will Purdue wants to do a better job defensively, then get up on the top side and not allow the pass to go in there. Use his long arms and make the Bulls try, Heat try to lob the ball inside to him.
Levingston comes in, as does Grant. So now we've got Purdue, Grant, Levingston, Armstrong, and Jordan on the floor for the Bulls. Cycley, 4 out of 4 from the line, 5 points, 4 rebounds. 2 blocks early in this ball game. In the first couple of minutes, it looked like Ronnie Cicely was in a daze. He got out of it quickly enough. Heat by 15. 10 minutes to go first half. Jordan with the fadeaway. He has 4.
That's a tough matchup for Brian Shaw. He has to back off. He's afraid of the penetration. And not only does Michael have speed, he has size on him as well.
Brian Shaw finds the opening for the shot, throws up a brick. Out of bounds, off cycle, Chicago ball. At the conclusion of tonight's game, Dick Versace and I will be selecting the Budweiser player of the game. Bimbo Coles, I told you, playing with a sore throat, had 100 degree temperature at the shoot-around today.
Playoff time, Bob. Just blow it off and play. Lace them up, go out and play.
Jordan with 2 consecutive field goals and now has 6. 38-27, Heat by 11. The adrenaline rush now settling down, and Miami's into a old-fashioned ball game here. Rice. This is the 3. Jordan.
Rice had a good long look.
Horace Grant kicks it back out to B.J. Armstrong. Bulls starting to rebound considerably better than they did in the first 5 minutes of this game. Jordan with a no-look pass. Cycley comes away with it. Cole to Cycley for the two-handed slam.
Ronnie Cicely active in the lane, reading the penetration of Bimbo Cole. Freed himself up for an easy slam.
Askins with a tough job trying to guard Grant.
I think Horace Grant's the most underrated player on the Bulls team, maybe one of the most underrated players in the league itself.
Grant at 6'10", Askins at 6'8". Simply no physical match for it. Nine on the shot clock. Glenn Rice into the paint. Jordan with that patented behind-the-back steal. Armstrong takes the hard foul from Bimbo Coles and will go to the line.
Well, if you're going to foul a guy, make sure that he can't shoot the free throw. When I watched that World War III game against New York and Detroit the other night, I guarantee you there were no layups given, no quarter given either. And I think what the Heat has to do is they have to realize, let's make a smart decision here. Are we going to take away the shot and the basket with this foul, or are we going to give a little love tap in there? Now they're looking at a three-point play. Potentially.
E.J. Armstrong.
In game one and two, Bob, I noticed that when Miami penetrates, they don't always do a good job of finding the open guy on the perimeter. Sometimes they kind of plan ahead and they say, okay, this is what I'm going to do. And then they go after it and make no adjustments on the way.
There's that intense pressure. Cycling had to bring the ball up the court. Bulls on an 11-4 run. Foul on Chicago. The Heat shot 67% in the first quarter, only 2-for-8 in this quarter as the Bulls have turned up their own heat. Armstrong second personal. Alan Ogg at 7-2, his second year from Alabama Birmingham, will be in the ballgame in a moment. Coming up at halftime, the Prudential Halftime Report with Ernie Johnson in our Atlanta studios with Hawks head coach Bobby Weiss. Hubie Brown will catch up with Trailblazer center Kevin Duckworth, and we'll also update you on the Phoenix San Antonio game three, which just started.
Right now, the Miami Heat's vulnerable. They've got Alan Ogg in there. They don't have much inside scoring. They keep asking. They got some help from Glenn Rice. Bimbo Coles has been shooting real well, 60% coming into this game. And then Kevin Edwards, who is not shooting well, right around 38%. They need some offense. They don't have it on the floor.
Jordan. Well, Miami is making them pay inside.
That's the right idea. Not that you're supposed to go over there and, you know, and hurt the guy. And you certainly don't want to hurt the league's premier player. But you want to make him take a difficult shot. As he gets in there should be a lot of white shirts in there. That's legitimate basketball. That's great NBA basketball. The NBA. No babies allowed.
Alan Ogg certainly isn't a baby. 7'2", 250 pounds. Scott Williams checking in his second appearance as Purdue goes to the bench. .737 to go in the first half. The Bulls have pulled to within 7. They had trailed by 15. Jordan has 6 points in the quarter, 8 points in the game. Edwards has it stripped by Jordan. Needs the break. Draws the foul. 8 points in the quarter.
Well, you got a series of complications here. We just talked about Kevin Edwards when he penetrates, not reading. He planned ahead. They closed off the gap. Now Michael Jordan's free to come down and do his thing. He's so dangerous in transition. Now you foul him. Now he dunks. Now they've got, you know, rhythm. They've got excitement. This is what they feed off of. They feed off of this guy, the greatest player to ever play the game of basketball. But he does miss occasionally.
Rice and Scott Williams will jump it up. Scott Williams out of North Carolina. Cliff Levinson is in the ball game for the Bulls right now. I liked your line, the sub du jour for the Bulls. And Jordan's going to get a rest. Pippen back in.
They've had good luck with the bench. The bench has served them well all year. And I believe to the fullest that Phil Jackson has played that bench. You can see the ball slip out of bounds. The little pressure down court has been a major problem. 15 steals in game two.
Kevin Edwards out of DePaul just bounced it off his foot. Big turnover there as the Bulls are on a run and trail now by only 5. 7:10 to go in the half. Pippen given the baseline by Edwards. Hands it off inside. loose ball foul on Livingston. Timeout on the floor. Heat leading by five.
All cars are made with sheets of metal. But one of these sheets is actually a sandwich of steel, resin, and steel, used by Lexus to help quiet the cabin of the LS400. Care to guess which one?
Bring the theater to your home with a Mitsubishi large screen TV or VCR from Wild West. We have Mitsubishi large screen TVs from 31 to 70 inches and VCRs with the fastest rewind time. Mitsubishi large screen TVs feature Diamond Vision for a brighter picture and longer tube life. Pay no money down and as little as $77 a month for a Mitsubishi big screen TV from Wild West. 2640 South Virginia in the heart of Reno, because we live here too.
Family after family made State Farm the largest insurer of cars and the largest insurer of homes. They made State Farm one of the largest and fastest growing of all life insurers, too. Because families are discovering the best agent for their car and their home and their other precious possessions is a State Farm agent.
In Reno, see Clark Tinsley on South Virginia, Robert Harris on South Wells Avenue, and John Buccambuso on West 4th Street.
15,008, and no one is more excited nor more proud than Louis Chaffel, the managing partner of the Miami Heat. Congratulations on going from an expansion team to a playoff team in four short years.
This is wonderful. I mean, this whole atmosphere, what's going on here is just unbelievable when you think not too long ago there wasn't even a building. Nobody thought pro basketball would ever make it in South Florida. But if there's ever been a doubt, it's diffused here tonight.
They doubted the location of the arena. They said people wouldn't come down here at night. They said that Miami only supported winners, but you proved them all wrong.
Well, they said a lot of things, but you give people what they want. You give them hardworking athletes. You give them a good night of fun and entertainment, and you have the NBA behind you.
What about those people that said you shouldn't have made the playoffs, but gone into the lottery?
They never played sports, and they were never here tonight.
Okay. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Bob.
6:55 to go in the half. Heat 41, Bulls 36. Rice. Livingston with a rebound. Miami shooting has gone south on him after shooting 67 in the first quarter, Dick. As you said, we might expect at least a decrease in that. Well, another shot clock here for Chicago.
You know, you've got to get some points off your defense. You just can't rely on your offensive output.
Purdue with a scoop shot and his first 2 points of the ball game. Career high in game number one for Purdue. He had 16 points in limited minutes.
He was the sub of the day.
7-0 Bulls run. It's a 3-point game. The Bulls. Purdue started that by tipping it away from Seigner. A chance the Bulls would have been one or better. It's a one-point game, and this crowd has been taken out of it momentarily, at least. Pippen with 17 points.
Well, when Louis Chaffel heard that they were going to be into the playoffs, he was watching the game in a bar, and his comment was, "I feel so good, so much emotion, and emotion is what carried his team early in this game. But they've got to knuckle down and play some defense. They've got to take better care of the ball, and they've got to handle the down-court pressure of the Chicago Bulls."
Heat holding on to the lead now with a big outside shot from Bimbo Cole. Pippen. He was bothered a bit by Kevin Edwards.
Now, that was a good challenge, and they need a lot more of those kinds of challenges defensively. Make the passes difficult for the Chicago Bulls.
Grant Long. He's got two. Just a couple of minutes of action. 43-40 Miami, 5 minutes to go, first half. Horace Grant, traveling. Steve Smith back into the ball game for Miami, and Michael Jordan for Chicago. Armstrong sits down as the Thimble Cool.
In the paper today, they had some reporter trying to explain the Chicago Bull triangle offense. It was dead wrong. You and I laughed about it over breakfast. But one of the things they can do in that triangle offense is post any player. Right now, they ought to think about posting Scottie Pippen on Kevin Edwards at the offensive end.
Edwards kicks it out to Rice. Threes in and out of there. Horace Grant to Pippen. He's got 19.
There's absolutely no way Kevin Edwards can stay matched up successfully on Scottie Pippen. He has too much size, too much athleticism, jumping ability, savvy, moxie, confidence.
1 point game. Got a switch. Steve Smith against Grant. He's going to launch one.
See, that's the absolute amazing thing about Horace Grant. You can put him on the point guard, and he's just as effective as he is on the power forward.
San Antonio up on Phoenix early. Smith stepped on the line, the reason for the turnover. We'll keep you posted on the other playoff games tonight. Portland and the Lakers come up right after this one. The Lakers trying to burst a sweep. Jordan over Steve Smith. And the Bulls have their first lead of the game. Miami had been up by 15, 44-43. Chicago, 3:43 to go in the half.
And Bob, that came on a wonderful shot on a fall away, fade away, lean back, impossible to challenge jump shot. Nothing but net. Curled in.
Fouls on Purdue for holding on to cycling. Jordan has 10 points in this quarter.
Right now, Miami's standing around offensively. They've got to get more movement. They've got to maybe clear a side, run a pick and roll, take advantage of the matchup with Steve Smith if they can. They've got to do something to make sure that the other people on the team touch leather on their trip down, maybe come down and get into a passing game, run something that's a little less predictable than what they're doing.
Clark will be checking back in here.
The more you stand around against the Chicago Bulls, the more their athleticism comes into play. They can step around for steals. They can double team. They can make you react at closing off lanes on penetration.
Cartwright's in for Purdue. Cycli can tie it if he hits the second of his two free throws. He's had a good first half. 9 points, five rebounds. There's that Chicago run. Michael Jordan, 10 of those 25 points in this quarter. It's tied at 44. Now, Cartwright, Pippen, Jordan, Grant, and Levingston on the floor for the Bulls. Shaw on Jordan. Good defense, but
Michael Jordan.
Kevin Lockley made a change. Brought in Steve Smith, took Kevin Edwards out, put Steve Smith on Pippen. Much better size matchup.
Trying to post up Cycli. Cartwright forced him way out of there. Gives him an opportunity to go to the hoop. The foul before the drive. Well, it's not a foul. It's illegal defense. And that's going to be a technical free throw for Miami. And they'll inbound the ball.
Michael Jordan gets into the lane, elevates, has a cup of tea, drops the basket in, and says, one lump or two.
3:03 to go in the half. Glenn Rice misses the technical free throw, but the Heat will get the ball out of bounds with a new shot clock. Free throws have been a problem for Miami. They have only taken 46 in this series.
Kevin Lockery wanted to get more free throws. He knows his team is the third best free throw shooting team in the NBA with a 79% average, but he has no way to take advantage of it if you're not going to punch the ball inside or take the ball off the dribble.
Big three-pointer from Steve Smith, and the Heat have regained the lead by one. After getting seven in the first quarter, Glenn Rice is 0-for-5 from the floor and scoreless here in the second quarter. Rice on Jordan. Chicago ball.
Timeout,
Chicago gets a timeout with 2:27 to go in the half. The Heat clinging tenaciously to a one-point lead.
It's the first week of spring training, and a bunch of nice old ladies show up.
Say cheese. Wonderful.
Nice, until we started working out.
You call that exercising?
Hey, Grandma, I don't see you doing it.
We finished?
In your dreams, homeboy.
Finally, cold buds for everybody.
Attaboy.
The Lexus Coupe can be equipped with a cellular phone that allows you to dial, answer, and hang up without ever letting go of the wheel. Proving once you get your hands on a Lexus, they tend to stay that way.
I think my dad works harder than any other dad in the world. But he still shows up at all my games. He says it's because he's such a great guy. I think it's because he put a phone in his truck. I think I play better when he's here.
The first playoff game in Miami Heat history. They're trailing Chicago 2-0 in this first round and are leading, however, here in the first half, 47-46 with 2:27 to go. This is the first of our doubleheader tonight on TNT. We'll be going out to Los Angeles, where Hubie Brown will team up with Pete Van Wieren to bring you that game, and then we'll also have bonus coverage of the game between San Antonio and Phoenix.
Wayne Huizenga, owner of the Marlins. We have all kinds of stars here.
Marlins have sold 10,000 season tickets for their first season.
Hold it.
Jordan. Oh, my.
Right now, Bob, there's no reason that the Miami Heat shouldn't be feeling good about themselves. It's just they started with a feeding frenzy, had the crowd involved. Chicago Bulls caught up, but I mean, they're right in the ball game. If they went into this game saying, could we be 47-48 with 2:02 left in the half, will we take it? They'd have taken it easily. They should be very happy about how they're playing.
The five on the shot clock got a foul on John Paxson. Oh, hold it. Maybe Armstrong. Let's make sure. It's back.
Michael makes a very difficult move there. You've got to move the bodies inside, and you've got to make him elevate vertically and not let him elevate towards the basket. Once he does that, he gets creative and he starts to do things that you've never seen before.
I wonder what that conversation's about. Doral, the Blue Monster, did you bring your clubs?
Well, with Jeff Kersey, it could be a variety of subjects.
By the way, Jeff Kersey did not call that foul on Paxson. That was his initial indication. Changed it to Scottie Pippen. And this game's tied at 48. Enjoyed the story about Phil Jackson, who does not allow golf clubs on the playoff charter, of course. They find golf clubs when they get here, but he immediately thinks they're Michael's. Turns out they belong to one of the Chicago announcers.
Yeah, Tom Doerr's club. They would be Tom Doerr's 7-3. I don't think those are Michael's clubs.
Pippen had a moment in the lane. Got the bottom of the iron. Heat leading it by one. Inside to Steve Smith.
It's all about choices right now. There's an excellent choice.
What a move by the rookie from Michigan
State. Some rookie. Yo.
Only played in 61 games, had a serious knee injury, difficult family problem. Played through all the adversity.
I put it in the Versace computer. He will be a star in this league.
Traveling on Cartwright. The Heat with a three-point lead and a minute 10 to go in the half, and this crowd is back in the ballgame.
Hello.
Shaw, Long, Cicely, Rice, and Smith on the floor for Miami.
Good movement, good movement.
Seven on the shot clock. Over the top, it'll belong to Chicago with 48 to go in the quarter. You could not find a ticket for this basketball game. There were notices in the newspaper here in Miami that police would be closely watching scalping outside the door. Jordan in heavy traffic draws the foul with 37 seconds.
Well, I'll tell you what, I like the defense that time because they did bring the bodies. They took away that inside lean move where he gets so creative and he made him fade away, but they put a little body on him, a little too much body. I think when you play Michael Jordan, if you can make him elevate up, then he's left with a jump shot. Maybe you can disturb his vision of the basket, but if you let him lean, you're in big trouble.
Jordan has 14 in this quarter, 15 in the quarter. Coming up at halftime, Bobby Weiss in the studios with Ernie Johnson Jr. Hubie Brown talks to Kevin Duckworth out on the left coast. An update on that Suns-Spurs game. You saw the Spurs trying to avert a sweep down in San Antonio, leading 21-14 early in the game.
I look for the Spurs to win that game. I think they'll win it.
Miami ball, 36 seconds to go in the half. Here's the pressure. Lightly applied this time. Down inside to Rice. Big bucket for
the How about the pass from Steve Smith? That was three-quarter court. That's about 75 feet on the money to Glenn Rice underneath.
Beat by four. Pippen finally denied a shot at the basket. With nine to shoot, Jordan. 16 in the quarter.
Well, that's the problem with playing Michael Jordan, Bob. You can do everything right, and he scores anyway.
Nice pressure. Ball handling. Steve Smith hits the three. 56-51.
I love this rookie. Scotty Pippen.
Well, they're on their feet at the Miami Arena. The Heat leading it by five. Steve Smith has 15.
In the aisles. They're clacking. The crickets are cricketing.
Check this out. What a rookie. Cool as can be. That's three. Steve Smith. Steve Arama.
The 1992 NBA playoffs are brought to you by Lexus Luxury Automobiles, the result of a relentless pursuit of perfection, and by Coca-Cola Classic. You can't beat the real thing.
Lexus LS400 features a very sophisticated suspension system. So while life may have its rough stretches, your ride through it won't.
So our lab guys wanted me to explain the advanced formula in new Raindance car polish. I told them, hey, forget that. Just show how easy it is to wipe off. They said no. They'd rather show how new Raindance lasts longer than those once-a-year polishes. Something about this special ingredient makes water beat up better longer. I said, nah, show the car. They said no. Maybe the bottle. I said car. They said bottle. New Raindance. Hey, you can't argue with science. You'll find advanced formula Raindance at these fine stores.
I was already late for my meeting when my flight landed. Lucky for me, someone left a courtesy car. I had to get the dollar rent a car fast. I knew they were right on the airport with low rates.
Welcome to Dollar.
Hello, I have a car rental reservation.
No problem. I'll just punch it up on the computer. Dollar Rent-A-Car is right on the airport, right on the money, with unlimited mileage and locations worldwide. Call your travel consultant or Dollar at 1-800-800-4000.
Ernie Johnson in Atlanta coming right up. It's the Prudential Halftime Report. Hawks head coach Bob Weiss offers his playoff insights. We'll look ahead to the second half of our doubleheader. You'll hear from the Blazers' Kevin Duckworth. And we'll update you on the Suns and the Spurs, Game 3. All of that on the Prudential Halftime Report next.
Baseball like Upper Deck. Look for 2,500 personally autographed cards by Ted Williams now in Upper Deck foil packs.
In trying to make an artistic statement, one should be careful not to let one's personal aroma do the talking. In order not to offend the critics, I recommend Rightguard Sport Stick. It provides maximum protection and the freshest scents, a sublime palette of odoriferous emanation. After all, a true artiste should be remembered for his inspiration, not his perspiration. Right Guard Sports Stick. Anything less would be uncivilized.
I think the customers definitely sense the difference, not only in the company, but in us.
There is a definite pride in what we do and how we do it.
I mean, the employees own the company. You are Avis. I'm Avis.
If you've seen our roving rapid return now, you'll see that you don't even have to step out of the car before you're already checked in.
If you don't like the color of the car, if I have a different color car, I'll fix it.
We call over 1,500 customers a month just to see if they're satisfied.
There's a big sense of pride in owning a company.
So why rent from anyone but an owner?
Why shouldn't I drop out of school?
Think for a minute and use your head.
What is the alternative?
Think for a minute and use your head.
Most of the people who quit 3, 4, 5 years down the road, which they were back in school and which they got their degree.
Think for a minute and use your head.
If you make good decisions today, you'll give yourself choices for the future.
When you make the right decisions, the right things happen.
Think for a minute and use your head.
Stay in school. It's your best move.
The Prudential Halftime Report is brought to you by The Prudential. In a changing world, one thing remains rock solid. The Prudential.
Well, they've made clacking an art form at Miami Arena. The Heat with a 56-51 lead over the Chicago Bulls. They are at the half at Miami Arena. Ernie Johnson here in Atlanta with the Prudential Halftime Report, joined by Bob Weiss, the head coach of the Atlanta Hawks. You told me before the game, hey, Miami's got talent. They play well at home. They're going to give Chicago a good game, and you're right.
Well, I must say, I said they could give them a good game, and fortunately, it's turning out that way. A great ball game. Miami came out blistering hot, very, very high as a result of the fans and the uproar there. Shot 67%, and I think they caught Chicago napping a little bit, too.
Well, let's see what they did. Let's go to the telestrator, and point went out for me here.
This play is a good example of just kind of the way things went. Miami was very aggressive. Here you'll see a drive to the basket. He's picked up here, but look at the weak side. Nobody stepping in, gives Cicely a clear lane to the basket, and that kind of told the whole story of the beginning of the ball game.
Ronnie Cicely strong to the hole, 56-51. Miami with the lead over Chicago with 24 minutes to play. Elsewhere tonight, the Phoenix Suns and the San Antonio Spurs. Phoenix has a chance to close them out. Strickland's not playing. Robinson's not playing. Willie Anderson's not playing. Nobody's playing for these guys, but somehow they still have the lead. Sabalos gets his shot blocked. Phoenix with an early lead, but back comes San Antonio. Terry Cummings has been red hot. Paul Pressey gets hot right here. That is a three-pointer. They got a six-point lead. And then it's Paul Pressey again. This one won't go, but Antoine Carr subbing for the Admiral, working off the glass, and the big guy throws it down. San Antonio hanging tough. Second period, they've got the lead over Phoenix, 27-24. And you take a look at the summary of this series so far. Phoenix with a huge rebounding advantage, Coach. And how do you explain this? The Spurs shooting a better field goal percentage, but trailing 0-2.
Well, it's exactly those numbers. They're trailing miserably in rebounding. Of course, David Robinson's not there. Turnover's a big factor, and they're not getting to the free throw line as much as Phoenix is, and those are the numbers that are telling the story there.
When the Prudential Halftime Report continues, you know we have another game to go tonight, the Portland Trail Blazers, the L.A. Lakers at the Great Western Forum. Hubie Brown talks to Kevin Duckworth when we come back.
Thank you.
world of constant change, there is one certainty. The financial strength of the rock. The Prudential, rock solid.
At the break at Miami Arena, the Bulls in the Heat on TNT as the Prudential halftime report continues. Still to come tonight, game two of our doubleheader. The LA Lakers playing host to the Portland Trail Blazers. The Lakers trying to avoid a sweep. It's been all Portland. Just about ran them out of the gym in both of the games. In game two, Kevin Duckworth had 19 points to lead a great Portland attack. And our Hubie Brown had a chance to spend some time with Duckworth.
Kevin, you're steamrolling. Games one and two, nothing but a walkover versus the Lakers. You're dominating the boards, dominating the point spread. Are you guys at the top of your game right now?
Well, I don't feel that we are exactly at the top of it, but I think we're on our way. We play well both games.
Now, the much-heralded matchup, Kevin Duckworth versus Vlade Divac. You call him a wimp. Now, is that what's happening? Well, what's causing all of this in this rivalry?
I didn't call him a wimp. Only thing I was talking about was the people who flop, to me, is a wimp thing. You know, it wasn't like I called Vlade a wimp. I don't think he's a wimp. I think he's a very talented ball player. I just feel that referees see guys who flop. I think they shouldn't be able to get the calls. I mean, come on, you think a guy can throw somebody across the lane with a finger?
Yeah, but I tell you, you're pretty big. I saw that sumo wrestler in Japan today. I think you could handle him. Come on.
But I've seen wrestlers can do that. No, it just doesn't happen that easy.
All right, let's talk about the matchup itself. 31 minutes a game. Divac in the first two only averaging 7 points, five rebounds. Do you feel a vindication from last year's semifinal loss, or do you feel that, you know, you match up quite well with him?
Well, I feel good, you know, from last year's playoffs, but I think that, you know, I match up pretty good against him, too. It's just a matter of me being able to go back at him. You know, a lot of times I played against him. He was getting more shots than I was, and I was always working on D, trying to defend him. But, you know, last two games really helped me a lot because I think that I was able to get a lot more shots than he was.
Well, you know, I look at you and I really like your offensive game. I think that you have a tremendous amount of moves to the basket. But now you're on a team, six guys in double figures, high-scoring ball club. You only get 10 shots a game, but people forget. You're an all-star player. You've been in the all-star game two times. How difficult is it for you to only get a limited number of shots every night?
Well, it's difficult. This year was very difficult because I was getting shots under six. Under 10. So, yeah, it's difficult. But then again, when you're winning, things going well, everything's looking good, you tend to overlook a lot of things. You know, I don't have to get 10 shots a game if we win it like we did this year. And so, you know, as long as we continue to win, you know, I can't complain about nothing.
I'm going to ask you one last question. Are you appreciated or unappreciated in the city of Portland? Come on,
I think I'm appreciated for most fans, but some of them I'm still not appreciated.
Yeah, but that's life, right?
That's life, but I'm going to tell you what, I'm going to stay in Portland and enjoy every bit of it.
That's wonderful. You make a great contribution to the team, and, you know, we really enjoy watching you play. You're really a tremendous talent. Good luck, Kevin.
Thank you very much.
Hubie and Duck in L.A. Now, Coach, on a team that has Drexler and has Kersey and Porter, why is Duckworth always fingered as the key to the series?
Well, a lot of times what happens is in a clutch situation, you'll start going to just those people you mentioned. And so a guy like Duckworth, his numbers will just automatically drop because the coach is going to someone else. It makes him an easy target.
Kevin Duckworth, 19 points in game two. He was the man in the middle. He's a key as they go to game three tonight at the Great Western Forum. That's game two of our doubleheader. The Blazers and the Lakers still to come tonight on TV.